Hello and welcome to my channel Intraday Wave. Today I'll discuss with you how to find high beta stocks, which is quite helpful for your day trading. If you googled about high beta stocks, you will find various resources available, and what is high beta stocks and how to generate that. But I'll discuss with you some new techniques and unique concepts so that you can build your own scanner to find out high beta stocks and short it out for your day trading purpose as well. So let's discuss this in the thread where, and I will request you to be patient and be watch this video till the end. It may be a bit of lengthy, but I'd like to request you to watch this video at the till the end so that you can make able to build your own scanner and do the trade accordingly. Okay, let's see what is beta. There is a definition, and you'll find that beta is a measures of stocks volatility. In nutshell, if we see that a particular stocks having beta more than one, there is a high probability that stocks give some kind of movement for day trading. And if we talk about FNO sector stocks, we have witnessed that stocks having beta more than 1.5 to 2, and the market price of the stocks, if it is within in between 200 to 700, there is a greater chance that stocks may give some directional movement for day trading. So we'll discuss with you in later how to find such kind of stocks and such high beta stocks using our own scanner. So let's discuss in next. One thing I would like to mention here, that here for educational purpose I have mentioned only about the stocks which are under FNO sector. And if you want to find out the beta stocks for cash segment also, you can do that according to your own needs. But here I am discussing about only the stocks which are belonging to FNO sector. And to get beta of any particular stock, you need to compare that stocks with relevant index. Suppose if you are selecting any stocks, say for Nifty 50, so then you need to get the return of the particular stock and compare the stocks with the particular index, and accordingly you will find out the beta of that stocks, though there are certain formula involved, and I will later explain with you how to use that formula so that you can get beta of any particular stocks. Nifty 50, and similarly I will do copy all the remaining index, major indexes also. So let me allow to download that files. First I will download the Nifty 50, and I have already downloaded that file, you can see here. So I need to copy the symbol only, so let it copy and put in different sheets. I have already copied the Nifty 50, so similarly I will download the remaining indexes also. So I need to copy the exact nomenclature of Nifty 50. And one thing I would like to share you, that I have already downloaded the index file, that is Nifty 50, Nifty Next 50, Mid Cap 50, and so on. So I would need to copy that exact nomenclature of relevant indexes, which can Google Finance easily recognize. So in case of Nifty 50, Google Finance has defined it as a Nifty. So I would like to copy the Nifty only, Nifty, and I will copy the remaining rows. And I have used the VLOOKUP functions, and you can see that the respective stocks which are belonging in under Nifty 50, it has already shown here. So I will do the same process for the remaining indexes also, and it will give the exact index of that particular stock. So instead of doing manually, we will use some kind of formula. So let it use if if B, sorry, if B2 not equals to blank, then B2, and if C2 not equals to blank, then C2, if D2 not equals to blank, then D2, if E2 not equals to blank, then E2, if F2 not equals to blank, then F2, else G2. So we need to close that bracket. The number of ifs we have used here, and we have used if 1 times 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we need to put the second bracket of 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have done almost, and we would like to copy that the file, and we have selected all the indexes of that particular stock. See, you can see here. So now I am, what I will doing, I just copied that value and paste it as a special. So paste, I will paste the value, so there will be no no formula. You can see there is no formula, though we have fetched the data using VLOOKUP, and after doing that we just simply copy that value and paste it as special value. So the all the formulas we have used, it will be hide. So we have done already almost, and now we'd like to place it in our Google Finance sheet. So you can do all the remaining all the files, you can delete that, and we have fetched the data under which category all the stocks are belonging. So now we will copy that exact file to Google Sheet, and I will show you how to use that formula in a Google Sheet to find the beta stocks.